Hi, I'm producing this video because some of you are having difficulty with the unequal slope rafter problem. So this is going to be out there on D2L so that you can review it anytime you want. First of all, let's just talk about this unequal sloped rafter problem. We have side A and side B. We have a 8 over 12 on the steep side and a 3 over 12 slope on the low slope side. We have a building width of 7200 and a typical overhang of 600. And now the important thing with this unequal sloped rafter problem and the way we like to build these, we want to make sure that that overhang is the same, and not only that, but that it's at the same elevation. So you can see that here in my AutoCAD drawing, I've got the soffits at the same elevation. So the run of the A side, including overhang, will be that distance there. And then the run of the rafter on the B side, including overhang, will be this distance here. So our first step in this problem is to try and make sure that our rises are similar. Now, we're not changing the proportion of either of those slopes. We're just making sure that the rises are the same. So we start with an 8 over 12, and we have a 3 over 12. The easiest way to do that is just to multiply the rises by each other. So 8 times 3 multiplied by the bottom by the same, and on the other side 3 times 8. So on the left side, or the A side, we get 24 out of 36 for a slope, and on the right side we get 24 out of 96. So what that means is we have 36 units of run on the left side and 96 on the right, for a total of 132 units of run. So that's important. So we really don't need this anymore. I'm going to get rid of that. Just clean this up a little bit. Okay, next step. I have 132 total units of run across the bottom. That includes overhang. On the left side, or A side, 36 out of those 132 units are used up. And on the right side, 96 out of those 132 units are used up. So right off the bat, I can convert these fractions to a decimal. And what I end up with is 36 divided by 132 is 27.3%. And on the right side, I end up with 72.7%. Okay. Again, if we look at the drawing below, I can say that this distance is 27.3% of the whole distance. And this one here is 72.7%. Okay, next step, building plus two overhangs. So 7200 plus 1200 equals 8400. So on the steep side, it would be 8400 times 0.273 is equal to 2,293.2. And on the right side, it would be 8,400 times 0.727%. And this is equal to 6,106.8. Now, we know that this distance here is 6,106.8, and on the left-hand side, 2,293.2. But what about the sloping length of the rafter now that we know the run? Well, I can take the run of the rafter on the left-hand side, 2,293.2, subtract an overhang, And that will give me 1,693.2, and that'll be the run of the common, not including overhang, because of course the overhang is 600. I can take that number, 1,693.2, and multiply it by the slope gain factor for that side, which I've calculated beforehand as 1.202, and that'll give me 2,035. So that tells me that this distance here is 2,035. Now the overhang, which is 600 times 1.202, is equal to 721. Now I know where my layout will be on a rafter for my three plumb lines. Oh, how about the right side? Well, it's just the same. I'm going to take the run of the rafter, including overhang, 6106.8 minus 600 is equal to 1690. Oh, sorry, I just misread there. So 6106.8 minus 600 is 5,506.8. So I can take that number, 5,506.8, multiply it by the slope gain factor for that side, which is 1.031, and I end up with 5,678, which I'm rounding. And then I can take my overhang, 600 times 1.031 is equal to 619. So on my right side, this distance here, 5,678, and my overhang, 619.